All right. Good morning, everybody. This is Karla. It is November 5th, and so excited to be on the call with you guys today. And well, you know, I know that this is we're on the second series of our calls, and you know, one of the things that we're going to be doing in this series, especially because the holidays are coming around and stuff like that, is I thought, what kinds of skills would really help you guys and your team really stay on track? And more importantly, what kinds of things could you learn as a leader to be able to be on track or help your guys be on track? So I thought that what one of the things I think would be a great topic for today is what is the quickest way to gain leadership, and that is through problem-solving skills. You know, as you guys know, there are always going to be problems out there, but it is those people that have the ability and the skill set that have the ability and the skill set to help other people learn how to solve problems that will win. So here's the first thing I want you to put on your notes, okay? Again, this is going to be like probably every time we get on the call, is that everything rises and falls in leadership, everything. And while you could say, well, you know, it's not fair, or why does everything have to be with me? You know, for me sometimes, you know, I get phone calls and people are telling me, oh, my God, you know, this problem and that problem. And I'll admit, sometimes I'm like, God, why are they always telling me? But here's the thing you guys got to get. Everything rises and falls in leadership. And people, you know, society out there, they are looking for somebody. They're looking for people to help them, guide them, and teach them how to solve problems. So, but here's a skill you want to learn while you yourself as a leader want to learn how to problem solve. You also don't want to give everybody the like solution right off the top, right? So let's go ahead and go why there are four reasons why people don't perform as they should, okay? So we're going to start with that topic right now. So whenever you want to get a piece of paper and a pencil, this is really going to be helpful. So there's four reasons why people don't perform as they should. Number one, they don't know what they're supposed to do. So, like, let's say, for example, I'm going to do something really simple. Like, somebody purchases, like, an ultimate program of skin, you know, the new Herbalife skincare, the Herbalife skin. Or they purchase, like, the whole line of Herbalife 24 or whatever that they purchase, or a cleansing program. But if people don't perform, it's probably one, because they don't know what they're supposed to do. So that's like, right, why you want to give somebody instructions, whether it's a sheet of paper telling them how to take the program, etc. But let's talk about on the business aspect. If somebody's not taking actions and they're not moving forward, especially let's say you just signed somebody up, you just registered them, and you have been doing this business for a while, and maybe you didn't have anybody telling you what to do because you're like a self-initiator. I know for myself, even though my parents were my sponsors, you know, they were never around. So I took it upon myself to go and watch videos on HBN, on myherbalife.com. I like self-educated myself, right? So, but then again, I was also trying to figure out what I was supposed to do, and I went out and got it. Now, you have to acknowledge that most people are not self-initiators. So as a leader, the number one thing we must do, especially like when you sign a new person up or whatever, maybe you're coaching a soccer game, a soccer team, you've got to tell them what they're supposed to do. So number one, people, if they're not performing, you got to stop and ask them. Let me ask you a question. Do you know what you're supposed to do? And I bet you 99.9% of the time they're going to be like, no, right? So that's one thing. They don't know what they're supposed to do. Okay, number two, they don't know how to do it. So maybe they know what they're supposed to do, but they don't know how to go about it, okay? So once they know, okay, you know what, this is how you're supposed to play the game with soccer, okay, this is how, so now that you've got licensed and registered, these are the steps you want to follow. Number one, you know, get on the program. And now you have to show them how to do that, or go order your nutritional program. And you are thinking, hello, go on the internet and call Herbalife or whatever and place your order. Again, as a leader, you must not assume that they know, okay? And if you really want the brand new babies in your business, okay, to really move forward, if you hold them by the hand, like a little bit, not too much, right, but just a little bit, where you're guiding them, okay, now you do this, and you're training them on how to, in the future, not depend on you. So, number one, they don't know what they're supposed to do. Number two, they don't know how to do it. Number three, they don't know why they should do it. Okay? So here's something that is really, really important, because somebody might know what to do and they might know how to do it, but if they're not moving and they're not performing, it's because they don't know why they're supposed to do it. Like, for example, let's say, you know, you just sign somebody up and they know that they're supposed to get on the program. They know that they know how to order, but then they're like buying products from like the neighbor or something, right? It's so important that you tell them, you know, why they're supposed to order the product directly through Herbalife. And you sit there and you explain to them, not when the problem arises, but beforehand, like, look, let me tell you, now that you have a license and membership, you know, you're going to be accumulating your volumes, and you want to make sure that you order directly through Herbalife because of this, 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 and these are the benefits, et cetera. Once you get licensed and registered with somebody, you're supposed to do, you're told, okay, one of the things you're supposed to do is go get training. How you do it is we have Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, so we have the STS coming up in Santa Clara, right, this weekend. And you start telling them all this stuff, and then you tell them that's not enough. Now you got to also tell them why they're supposed to go to this STS in Santa Clara. So once you do that, guess what's going to happen? People are going to understand not only what they're supposed to do, how to do it, but why they're supposed to do it. Now, number four, and that is, there are obstacles beyond their control, okay? There are obstacles beyond their control. We're going to talk about that in a little bit. So number one, they don't know what they're supposed to do. Number two, they don't know how to do it. Number three, they don't know why they should do it. And number four, which is, I'm going to talk about that later, there are obstacles beyond their control, okay? Now, these are all responsibilities of leadership. So I have good news for you and I have bad news, but I have more good than that, right? These four things, the how to problem solve, these are all responsibilities of you. If you want to be seen as a leader in your organization, these are things that you must take upon yourself and your team. You've got to tell them what they're supposed to do, how to do it, why they're supposed to do it, okay? And then we're going to, number four is kind of on its own, but we'll talk about this later. Now, the first thing, the first three of them, it's just dealing with how to start your job correctly, how to start your business appropriately, how to use the program. So it's just putting a system or like some kind of training along with good communication that will be effective in resolving these three first issues. So if you have a system that will show people what they're supposed to do, how to do it, and why they're supposed to do it, you have trainings, and then every HOM, every boot camp, every weight loss challenge, every wellness evaluation, every time you're in front of somebody, keep those three things in mind. I'm going to tell them what they're supposed to do, how to do it, and why. Okay, so it's like what, how, and why. And you keep those three things in mind, and you're going to be able to resolve a lot of future problem solving, a lot of future problems, okay? So that's a great way for problem solving in an effective way of how to deal with those three issues. Now, if problems continue to occur, like let's say they know, but they continue to occur, the climate that makes those, there's something that's going on that you got to kind of dig deeper, right? Like you got to kind of see what is going on there. And if you're willing and able to either attack their problems or train them on how to go about certain things that they're stuck in, okay, you will always be seen as that leader that they can go to. So I'm going to do that again. So if there's problems, like let's say they already know what to do, how to do it, and why they should do it, but maybe there are the number four, there's obstacles beyond their control. If you're willing to take some time and look at it and dig deep and start asking a lot of questions, like, okay, well, do you know what you're supposed to do? No, yeah, I know. Do you know, like, how to take the program? Yeah. Do you know, like, why? Like, the two shakes, one meal, the calories, da, da, da. Yeah, I know. But they're not moving. They're still, like, stuck. Now it's like there's other obstacles, right, number four. And this number four is, like, what sets the, you know, the average from the champion. And that is you taking the time, write this down, to really care. Now, here's the thing, and all of us, including myself, have to do a better job with this, and that is asking a lot more questions than what you're talking. Because sometimes you want to be like, well, you're just lazy, or like, right? I don't ever say that, but like, you just want to like shout out what you see as being that obstacle, like, oh, you're just making excuses, or oh, whatever, right? But the reality is there's something more there for that person that's not allowing them to move forward. So if you can really dig deep in that, you know, people are always going to go to you, because the reality is there always will be a need for people that can solve problem solve, because people will always have problems. I mean, that's just the act, you know, the way that the, you know, the way life is. Now, there's two things that are needed to effectively solve problems. Number one, to have the right attitude. And number two, to have the right action plan. Okay? So if this person is like willing, you know, like they're stuck and they're like, I really want to. But so now what we need to look at is, do they have the right attitude to look deep in as far as like what is stopping them? And now let's get them the right action plan for them. For example, let's say it's like the products, right? And somebody knows what to do, how to do it, and why they should do it, but something's stuck. And then you start asking them questions. Okay, so what? No, you know what? It's just really challenging. Like, actually, my girlfriend right now, she was telling me, you know, that last night they went out to dinner, and there was like pizza and all this stuff, right? So I said, you know what? So now she's got the right attitude, because she definitely wants to, you know, stay on track with her nutritional program. So then now let's give her the right action plan. I said, you know what? One of the things that might help you, because like I went dancing last night, and like at midnight I get a phone call, like 11:30 I get a phone call. I finished a meeting, and about 10:30 we were done, and then all of a sudden they're like, let's go dancing. And I'm like, really? Like, I want to go home, right? And then, anyway, long story short, about 11 o'clock, we end up going, like, to some restaurant place that they had dancing. Well, after, like, around 1 o'clock when we were coming home, everybody was, like, so hungry, right? And, of course, what does everybody want to eat at 1 o'clock in the morning after they've been dancing? Like, junk food. But guess what? I had the right attitude. I was like, I'm you know, and I had the right action plan. So I had, like, beverage mix with me and a bottle of water. So what I did is I ate the beverage mix dry and drank the water. You know, because for some reason, I don't know why, but when I eat it dry, like it tastes like candy to me, and it fills me up with a bottle of water. So I had the right action plan. So I was telling my girlfriend, I'm like, you know, you just carry food with you, like always have stuff in the car. So if you get caught up in those situations where you're not, you know, wanting to eat what they're eating, you always have an option. You know, I always have like protein bars. I have the new meal plan. You know, again, the other night, I don't know where I was. And I went to go see a friend who launched a new artist. And it was getting late, and I was getting hungry, and there was nothing around that was healthy. And I was like, oh, I have my meal bar. So I ate it slowly with a big old thing of water, like a little bit at a time. So you're always prepared. See, so there it is, right? She knows what to do, how to do it, why to do it, but she's still stuck. So now I found out that it's because she gets herself in situations that sometimes doesn't, like, favor her. So, boom, we put a right action plan. So that's how you can go about it for a client. Now, for a distributor, for example, let's say they say, well, you know, I know what to do, how to do it, and why I should do it, but then they're still stuck. If you start asking them questions, and then you might come to find out that maybe it's because, you know, they want to go to the training, but they were shy to tell you that they didn't have a ride on how to get there, right? And they have the right attitude, right? They're like, I really want to go, but, you know, so anyhow, so now you can put together a plan of action. Like, you know what? Like last night, same thing. One of my friends was like, we want to meet. Probably all week next week, and it's like an hour drive for me. And I'm like, seriously, like I want to be here, but it's going to be hard for me because it's like so far away. And then boom, he gave me a right plan of action. He's like, well, you know what, why don't you take the metro down here? We went on the iPhone and we found out a way for me to get down the metro. So again, finding solutions. So don't, when somebody gives you like a stop, consider it like a yellow light where you're just having to like pause and think of other ways to resolve whatever it is that they feel that is getting in their way from not moving forward. So, you know, once they know what to do, how to do it, and why they should do it, if they're still not moving, start asking questions. And you be that person who's asking all those questions. So what else do you think you could do? So what do you feel is stopping you? And then you keep digging, and then they finally tell you what is that one obstacle that's standing in their way. Now you come up with ways of resolving that obstacle. Boom, now they're moving forward, okay, if that's really what they want. Okay, so it's, you know, I can't stress this enough because so many times we get people in our organizations or in our business or in our clients that we sometimes can even get frustrated, like, why are they not doing what they said they were going to do? Well, let's stop and ask them why that is, okay? So here's the deal, you know, the problem of mass ignorance, okay, it's like people think, oh, that's just the way they are, or they're just lazy, or they start labeling people It's just they're lacking education, okay? So examples of, like, great people or, like, highly successful people, they all will reveal that they had challenges and that they were able to overcome those problems, okay? So here's the deal. Like, whenever you hear a bunch of, like, presidency members up on stage at extravaganza and they're totally crying, one of the reasons why some the people that really move you, when they start sharing all their obstacles, like, you know, like Gary, who was living in his, you know, in his car for so long, he was homeless, right? Or like somebody else who could say, you know, all these things happened to me. And so when they start to reveal, like, you really, the people that you admire, if you really think about it, people that you really look up to, are the people that are willing to reveal, like, all their obstacles and how they were able to overcome them. So as for us, as the audience, or like if you tell your client or your distributor, you start sharing with them, you know what, that was really hard for me too. Like, you know, I would always go out with my friends and they were always eating all this stuff. And so one of the ways that I helped get over that was I always carried, you know, like an apple and a string cheese, or I always carry like a protein bar. I always carry like a, you know, cookies and cream meal replacement along with a bottle of water. So you start, so now they're not feeling like they're like aliens, right? Because it's ignorant to think that only that person has that problem, okay? So that is why we really have an admiration for them. You know, their attitude, they refuse to hold on to those common excuses for failure, okay? So those people that we really admire, they have that attitude where they see an obstacle, but they refuse to get stopped by that. And they just, you know, their ability to continue to break through is admirable, okay? So they turn their blocks, their blocking stone into stepping stone. I love that, right? They turn those blocks, like something, boom, like a block comes in front of them and somebody can get stopped and go, okay, well, I guess this is it. Like the way that they talk about the ants, that you know, one of the things that's admirable about the ants is that you could put like a little something in front of an ant, like if a bunch of ants are crawling down your whatever, your floor, and you put something in front of it, it doesn't like get faced by it and go, okay, well, I'm done. It doesn't just sit there or doesn't make a U-turn and go back. It actually goes, okay, and then it finds a way either to climb over it or climb around it. So as human beings, we need to keep that in mind that when something stops, like if you know you're going somewhere and you can get stopped by something, you just think, okay, no problem. Let me think, how else can I resolve it? Let me think, how else can I deal with this? If you're always in that mindset of how else, how else, how else, and you're asking yourself questions, trust me, maybe if the answer is not right there and then, you will eventually get it because your subconscious mind never stops, never. You know, I'm reading this book called by Louise Hay, it's Heal Your Life. I just finished reading it. I think I'm like a couple pages to finish it. And like I'm so sad I don't want to finish the book because it was so good. I highly recommend if you guys go on YouTube, there's a couple of audios of her book. But it's talking about like how the mindset works and how, you know, you manifest everything in your life and your subconscious mind just does not know. Just, you know, it doesn't know where to stop. And it will tell you. So I'll share something with you guys. I don't even know why I'm getting into this subject. But anyhow, for example, right, like whenever it's like 111, like I used to, I'm going to make up a wish so you don't know my wish. But like let's say I would say like I wish I had a red Lamborghini, right? And here's the thing that she said that, whenever you talk about like, you know, I will, you talk like that, like I wish, I will, and you're like talking like in the future, your brain doesn't go to work on it because you already put it like out there someday, you know, so it doesn't move things to bring it into fruition right now. But when you start talking from, you know, I own a red Lamborghini, you know, and you start visualizing it like you have it, like the now, your subconscious mind will start going to work on how to get it because it thinks that it already has it. So it's going to look for it, right? So So I was like, oh, my gosh, how many times whenever it's like 444 or 333, I'm like, I wish I had a beautiful red Lamborghini. Well, why? That's not my wish, but why I don't have it is because I'm always wishing for it in the future someday. So your body's like, your brain's like, okay, well, it's not important right now, so let's just like chill. It's in the future. But if you start declaring things like now, like, you know, like now I am whatever, you know, and you be very careful when you say the words I am. Because that's like an order. It's in that order. Like you're giving an order, a command to your subconscious mind that that is how you are, and therefore you will start acting at it. So be careful to not be like, I am dumb. I am lazy. Oh, my God, I'm so dumb. Like whenever I used to make a mistake, I used to be like, oh, my God, I'm so dumb. Right? Now I'm like, oops, delete. You know? So now I don't even say it anymore because I'm so aware of that. But so just to keep that in mind, I don't even know why I'm telling you this, you guys this, but either way, you know, back to the subject is that when you are having those obstacles that are in front of you, you got to start asking yourself, you know, how can I resolve this? What other way can I do it? How else can I, you know, you start asking yourself questions and your subconscious mind will go to work on it until it resolves and finds an answer. So with that said, it's 9:25 exactly. I'm going to go ahead and open the lines and see if anybody has any comments or questions for the last 5 minutes. Okay, anybody have any comments or any questions about anything? Hello? Are you guys still there?
Yes.
Okay, great. Does anybody have any comments or any questions about anything, whether it's what we just talked about or anything during the week? I mean, from last week?
I don't, personally.
Okay. Okay, great. Anybody else want, is there anything else you guys would like to share? What has been going on? Anything that has happened that you can contribute to the rest of the group? You guys are my quiet group. Okay. All right, you guys. If you guys don't have any questions or any comments, no, going once, going twice? Okay. All right, so no problem.
No, I here's
know,
a, I know.
Okay.
All right.
Go ahead.
I have a comment. I've been practicing the I am the last week or so. Yeah, the last week. And when I came back from Las Vegas, I look at one of my pictures. I go, oh, no. I had gained 10 pounds for the last a year. And I said, oh, I just can't take it off no more. I can't take it off no more. And I said, uh-uh. So I started, I look at that and I go, okay, I am 160 pounds. I am 160 pounds. And I start doing it, and all of a sudden I start doing the dance. I start walking more, and I start doing so many different things that I was not doing anymore. I lost 7 pounds in 1 week, and I feel awesome. It's like I am. You know, I learned that from the other call. So I started last week.
Awesome, and let me add one more thing to that, okay? So this is so amazing, and here's the other thing. One of the things that I've been learning on this book, Lewis Hay, and I've heard this many, 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 many times. How many times have we heard people say, like, you really need to learn to love yourself, right? And I'm like, well, yeah, I love myself. And I'm like, yeah, I love myself. But no, like, really, really, like, love yourself. And so one of the things that she talks about is, like, when you really become grateful and appreciative, and you can, you know, whatever our trouble area is, our thighs, our belly, our, you know, our arms, whatever, and you just, like, you know, it sounds kind of weird, but you just start, like, touching them and, like, loving them and saying, you know, thank you, like, my thighs for helping me walk every day, and you just become really grateful for your body, because so many times, you know, if we really think about this, how our body takes us from A to Z every single day without us even asking it to, how it puts one foot in front of the other, how it digests your food, how your heart pulses, how your arms are able to grab onto things. And then they were like, oh my God, I hate my arms, right? And because they've got a little extra weight on them or whatever. Oh my God, I hate my butt or whatever, right? But if you think about it, if you start being grateful for your body and start being grateful for your body parts and start loving them and saying, you know, thank you thighs, thank you arms, and you get into that state of gratitude, your body's going to start to feel appreciated, almost like it's like another person, right? Like it starts to feel appreciated. And what happens when you start, if you tell your kids, you're dumb, you're dumb, you're dumb, I hate your arms, I hate your legs, they're not going to really feel valued, and therefore they're not going to really move forward with things. But if you start telling your body, thank you, you know, thank you, and thank God for everything you have, and that you have two legs, and you have two beautiful hips, and a beautiful butt to sit on, and beautiful lit arms to grab onto things, you start becoming grateful for your body's going to start to feel appreciated, therefore it's going to start changing. But so not only start saying, like, I am 168, but really be grateful for the beautiful, amazing body that you have that does what it does every single day without you even asking it to. So I know it sounds kind of weird, but like when you come out of the shower, just take a moment and like, or maybe when you're taking a shower, just really take a moment and really get present to what a blessing it is that you are whole and complete. Maybe a little too whole or too complete, but it's okay, you know, because there is no such thing. Like just really feel grateful for every body part that you have and watch. And you're going to start treating your body differently. Therefore, you're going to have better food choices. You know, I started doing this last week. And so guess what? Like I had one piece of candy yesterday because at the meeting that I was at, they had like a thing of candy and I had one. But you know, where before I probably would have felt like totally guilty if I had a bunch of candy or whatever, because if you don't appreciate something, you don't take care of it. But if you really appreciate and are grateful for your body, you're going to take care of it. You're going to want to feed it good, nurturing food. You're not going to give your body, or you're not going to give that thing that you love junk. So I was like, oh, my God, I love it. And so it's so true. So thank you for sharing that, Lily. And that's another thing that, you know, we can definitely transfer over to our clients to say, you know, if you really start becoming appreciative and grateful for your body, it's like if you love your kid, they're not going to give it like, you know, gasoline in their water bottle, right? You're going to give it like water and milk and whatever you give babies because you love that baby. You're not going to give it things that are going to harm it. Same thing with yourself. If you really are present to how wonderful your body is and how wonderful it is that it operates for you, you're not going to give it junk. You're going to give it things that are going to make it want to work better for you. I was like, oh, I love that. So anyway, I wanted to share that with you. So thank you for sharing that. Anybody else before we say goodbye?
I didn't get to be on the conference call last week, but the week before, you were talking about, you know, why people, they're resistant to change and how, you know, you need to tie it in with the psychological need.
Uh-huh.
Well, I found myself saying that like a lot when it came to change. Just a lot of people were just like, I found myself kind of having deeper conversations with people why they're wanting change, you know, not just the usual like, oh, well, I want to lose weight. But, you know, what is it in your life that's really impacting you? And how do you think that, you know, not just looking better, but feeling better, how do you think that's going to benefit you and help you and really kind of digging into their psyche as far as, you know, why they really need this change so that, you know, when they do come to me with questions or, you know, I'm not sure if I can do this kind of an attitude, then I can be productive with it and be like, you know, well, you know, you said you really wanted to do this. You know, you want to get healthy for your kids. You want to feel good again. You want to have energy again. I mean, imagine how you're going to feel a month from now versus how you feel right now. You know, you can do this, you have a support group. And I just find myself saying that a lot, like, what is the psychological need? So I just wanted to say thank you for that because it has helped me tremendously.
Oh, awesome. Thank you for sharing. I know that most people on the call could definitely benefit from that comment. So thank you so much for sharing. Awesome, awesome. Anybody else? Okay. All right, you guys, so hold on. Let me end the recording. Don't hang up.